Here we are. Hello everyone. Today I have some chrysanthemums in the blue jug. And I'm looking down on them, so that should make things interesting one way or another. So I guess I get cracking. Stop oil painting thrills and spills. Hold on to your seats. So I've got all this green and I've got all this red. So I've got this sort of warm reddish ground. So that actually is going to help with the background a bit. So I'll keep it neutral. I'll keep it sort of yellowy. Let's do some raw umber. Oh, yeah, stay where you are. So I've got the palette leaning at maximum. There's going to be lots of things rolling around today. Oh, yeah. I'm going to pinch some paint from another palette. Let's get the last of that good white out and add this to it. So this is my normal palette, which is almost impossible to see what's going on if you were looking at this. The glass palette with the grey paper for demonstration is a lot simpler to understand on a screen. Some of that yellow down there. Got a couple of reds, including a nice alizarin, which I'm definitely going to need. I'll put that there. Bit of stuff. Ultramarine. And a bit of Taylor cyanine green there, which I think will be useful. Quite a lot of raw umber over here, which is already trying to form a skin. So that needs a lumpy paint, which I do not want. Yeah, that'll make it a good grey. Pop this back. Warm brown down here. Right. So to begin with, there's this view looking down, so I'm going to do this, I'm going to be standing up, as you can probably tell, and put some rather nice angles on it. So the first one, about that. It's not necessarily going to go there. Probably go lower down. But once I've got that angle in, I can use that. I might say this is one I can place. Well, it's about the same. Which means that's about 45 degrees. That's coming off the bottom. So that'll be there. be up here somewhere. Actually, no, it won't. I've no idea yet. So maybe that will be parallel down here. Oh, about there. That might be more like it. More going on the left, so I'll push this over to the right, which will put this bit of light roughly in the middle. So if I pop that here, construction lines. I'll put my lights. Maybe with this one. About here, which I'm comfortable with. A bit of an explosion of reds going off there. A bit of negative space. So I hope you can hear me and everything's working okay. Some of the pinks there, that's going to line up. To one side of the center. Do a bit of measuring now. It's from the bottom of the jug to the bottom of the flowers. That's about the same distance. Oh, twice. So that'll be around where the bottom of the jug is. Which, yeah, seems to work out pretty well. That side will stick out over here somewhere. So I guess that's where that's going to go. There you are. Now I'm going to try and be quick and loose again. This is a big thing I've been working on. I think a lot of artists do. It's so easy to get caught up in being fiddly, but actually most of the big questions are answered with a simple approach. Okay, maybe a handle on that jug there, somewhere around there. Quite like this canvas in the background. I think I'm going to use that. And this has happened to be in roughly the right place. Yeah, this line. Yeah, where is that? Needs to go about here. Okay. Okay, there's some idea of that now. I'm going to do a very thin light wash, which I don't normally do, but it won't matter that it shows through. And I make it slightly bluey. Let's pop that here. I'm going to put a few of those lights around here and up here. Again, nothing too Not pinning anything down too much. Nothing I can't scrub back afterwards. So yeah, get a few colours in just so I can sort of see roughly where things go. And that darker red. I'll chuck some greens in the background as well, I think. Bluey greens. Pour a little bit of viridium. Calm that down a bit. Stick some blue in it. Tiny dab of white, just for some opacity. Not very much. These lights are going to come over, but warm that up a little bit more, I think. Make it browner. Oh, that's a blue. Well, it's quite the metropolis, this. I wonder what he's after. It's probably late for his dinner. Well, yeah, so Sherborne's been voted one of the best place to live in the Southwest by the Times. They quoted me in the article, which was a rather lame little puff piece, which has been nicely followed up by people trying to sell me vanity publishing in Vogue and, I don't know, World of Interiors and stuff like that. So yeah, I'm marked now. I did try and sort of point out what is actually good about Sherborne, which is there's decent people here who actually respect people who get on with things, but yeah, so hopefully that will now add itself to part of the advert. That was an unmarked police car as well, so don't know what they're up to. Alright, I'm finding my way into some of these bits and pieces now. That might have to move over a little bit. I'll have to make that jug a little bit bigger. That's okay. So yeah, so there's a bit of stuff going on. I'll get some of these darks in. And this is going to be very thin. It's not very meaningful painting yet. It's really just sort of getting some splodges in so I can see roughly what goes where. But and again, with flowers, the drawing head doesn't have to be super accurate. You know, it can be a little bit vague. So that is where the handle of the jug goes. Let's go here. So the bottom of the jug is gradually moving down. But actually, I think it needs to tuck in a bit. So if that's happening, Okay, let's get another brush, do a bit of clearing out. Piece of rag. Yeah, so I think it could be, I don't know if it's pathos, if the Sunday Times published it and not people of Sherborne themselves, but it's kind of asking for it, isn't it? Like parading the place around, going, oh, it's one of the best places to live, and it's the best place to live in the Southwest. What's going to happen next, really? Let's have a think about that. I think something's going to get discovered. Yeah. Hopefully nothing too horrible, but... I don't know, there might be all manner of things going on under the surface. Okay, yeah, I'm not 100% convinced about the shape of that jug. In fact, I'm not at all. That's going to come right in. Do a few other little bits and pieces, like, so I'm using this green again. I'm getting really quite fond of it, so I'm going to put a few lights in here. I can get lighter again afterwards. That sort of swell out a bit, dash in there. Again, it's not proper paint yet, so I'm not being overly fussy about it. But it's approaching some of the colours I'm going to want. And, it's quite fun to be mucking about with this already. That is going to follow on to a lighter version for the foreground. So I've got that angle still. I'm going to trust it to a certain extent. Bit of colour in there. And here, here's where it's going to get interesting. I've got this angle here. I'm going to trust that as well, see what it delivers. Line here, which I'm going to trust too. So I'm going to start to see this come together now. Okay. Darker one here, which is bluer. Is that too much? That's a little bit too much. Yeah, I can start to see that turn up. And I think I've got some colour reference here. I tell you what I will do, I'll do one more bit, which is going to be really just this background beigey colour. That's raw umber. Tiny smidge of this yellowy colour. And again, I'm putting quite a bit of thinners in it just to spread it out, but it's a long way off the white. I think I could be quite comfortable with that. No, it's not dark enough. Unless that green's going to have to be a lot lighter. Let's measure it. Oh, okay. Throw that directly in the paint. which is standard. Yep, that was textbook. Right, how bright is this going to get? Probably at least that bright. A bit more yellow in it. I don't know why I'm whispering. Okay, now I'm seeing the jump. A little bit brown, a tiny bit of blue. Yeah, that's more like it. So there's a background colour going in there. That's going to carry on up here. It's going to be a stretcher bar. And for the bits behind, I'm going to want to paint over. This is a good mix because that thin is going to evaporate and it's going to leave a very thin layer of really quite sticky paint. And when it does, I can use that to sort of work out from. So I hope everybody's doing well. And if you've got some painting experience with chrysanthemums, do share it with me, because I've honestly no idea how this is going to come out, but it's part of the fun, I guess, isn't it? Alright, a bit more negative space here. I'm sure everyone would like me to turn the camera around and find out what's going on outside, but see, it's good to have a loose grip on a brush, but it does mean I drop them fairly frequently. It's not a problem, it's because it's hold them very loosely and you get a bit more sensitivity with your marks and control over how much pressure you're putting on. There we go. Let's follow that down. Yes, there's some interesting bit of negative spaces going on. Oh, wakey wakey. Scrub that in. Yes, there'll be some relative colours to this. The white's not really going to be much different. It'll be slightly lighter. Slightly bluer, maybe, but yeah, let's do that now. I mean, it's possible I won't even have to go back to these. But these colours might be absolutely fine. It's a well-sized canvas, so it hasn't got loads of texture on it. Bit yellower than that. No, that's way too light. Let's try this. Yeah, it's averaging out somewhere around it. Guessing where that shadow is going to be, but Yeah, it's definitely browner now. I compare it to that green. Yeah, this green, in fact, which again is going to get slightly darker as it wanders across. So. Scrubbing that in, sort of coming together. Interesting, isn't it? Oh, right. Change my piece of rag. Yeah, right. Still white all over the handle of this brush, and now all over my hand. Let's see what we've got with us. Ah, a few comments, hello. Hi Josie. Lovely to see you here. Right, what are we in? 25 minutes in. I think I will mix up some colour now. If you've got something to say or question or whatever, do drop a little note in. I'm seeing a few new things now. That white's going to spread out. Well, I think the red will be okay. Some more of that green. Let's do a bit more of that. Kind of got it, but I don't know. A lot browner than that. This will go around here somewhere. Okay, those brushes a little clean. Let's go on to the palette can. And I'll mix up some of these, colours. I'm going to want some quantities of what I'd already mixed. So, a greyer version over here. Put some of that in. Let's see how that matches up. That's still pretty bright. I'm going to push that down a bit more. It's a tricky thing when you're mixing colours. There's this sort of, it feels wrong to be pushing them away from the colour you want, but green is rather lovely, but way too intense. So if I make a softer one, I can always turn the green up. So that works pretty well. So I've got a quantity of that now, which is good. this darker green. There are little lumps in this, but I think it'll be alright once it gets mixed up. Yeah, this is very, still, it's quite crisp. It's good for shadows, but I want to put some red in that somewhere down the line. I'll put that to one side. Do that again. Let's pop a bit of white in that. Stop revealing what kind of colour it is. And we can make a yellower version of that as and when we need it, which I'll probably go over here. It's just with white in it, makes that pretty much. There's an actual lump there I can remove. So we've got a pale yellow and a pale bluey green and a yellowy green. So there'll be a few brush mixes to find the right one when it comes to it, but I don't have to worry about that too much. Next thing I'm going to want more of is these background colours, because the negative spaces and putting those back in will be kind of important. So I'm going to need a quantity of this. Darker and a bit browner as well. Just borrow a little bit of red to stick in it. Hope it doesn't go too pink. Tiny dab of yellow. Where are we at? No, yellower. Actually, that might do for this. That's bluer there, but actually that's a bit more like it. I'm going to put some other colours into those background colours, but let's get a bit more yellow in this. Mix it properly. Let's see how that does for the background. It's a bit closer now. A bit greyer, so I'll pop a little bit of blue in it. A little bit of blue in this one first. I'll make a weaker blue. I can add in as much as I need. Don't risk pushing it too far that way. Oh, that's pretty good. Still a bit yellower. Rest of the blue into this mixer. Should do for over here, yeah. So when it comes to lightening it, that's a colour that will show through. It's a slightly lighter version of what's already there. So that should help lift it. Just mixing that up and separate these out a bit. Okay, so that's sort of my backgrounds. I got this green version, which I will use in the jug. I can use a bit of that. And some of this red to effectively make a black. This is warming that green up. I use all this red actually. Maybe a little dab of alizarin. Just to tip it over the edge. I don't think I'll be using that till the end. Okay, so the last thing is these flower colours. Now, that background colour needs to be... I've got this purple left over from before. It wants to be slightly darker, and that's probably around the right area. Add a bit of white to it. Let's see if that's still darker. Only just, but the colour's nice and strong, which I quite like. So I'll mix my light here as well for the chrysanthemums. Warm that up a little bit. It's quite yellowy, but it's not too bright. It's still a bit further I can go for very bright highlights. That'll do for starters. And then within that, I've got a slightly yellower version of this, just somewhere in between. It's going to get a little warmer as well. Yeah, so this is, again, this is going to be brush mixes when I get that far, so I'm not going to fuss about it too much. When I get to the front, it looks blue. These shadows in here, if I isolate them, they're actually a kind of a yellow colour, and they're pretty much the same as this background. That said, they are reading blue to me. So this is probably going too far, but if I get a bit of this and pop it there, take a bit of that blue and put it in there. That will probably work, he says. Okay, now we've got an interesting thing with these other ones. We've got the pink ones where they're in shadow. It's actually a far more intense colour. So I'm going to mix some violet here. That's too much red, too much blue, sorry. Pop a bit of that back. Still way too blue. Let's put that somewhere in the middle. Let's get a bit more of that red, put that here. Put a bit of white in it so we can see the colour. Now we're talking. That should appear a lot darker than this, which it does. And that's the kind of really intense colour. The lighter version, I'm going to use a cadmium red. And pop that here. It's going to need a lot more white in it. I'll put that over here. Yeah, so this is slightly more delicate pink we get out of that. And yeah, maybe that's too much. I think I can use that for the highlights on some of these other bits. A bit more alizarin. So there's a cool and a warm there. So that colour goes a long way. It should be considerably brighter than the background colour, which is that, which it is. Again, brush mixes could still go a bit further. For a core colour, that's good. Two more to go, which are for these darker flowers. And that is a really intense dark. And a ton of alizarin in there. I'm going to put that down here. Take a bit of that back. I'm going to put a little bit of white in just so that the colour reads. So I'm going to need some more alizarin, so I'll put some more of that out. And see what that message was. Very exciting. Permanent alizarin crimson. Yeah, so, yes, blocking in approximate colours. It means that there is a little layer of paint already down, which can make things tricky, but it's sort of more forgiving. So, you know, the one thing is to just get a tone on the surface so that you don't get white showing through when you've got little broken bits. The next stage from that would be to have a sort of an undercolour, so you've got a bit more context. Here it's the accuracy of the colour is going to make the flowers read more than anything else, because I'm not going to do every individual little petal. I'm not going to do all that detail, which means if the colours aren't balanced, if I haven't got the tones just right and haven't got the colours just right, it's not going to play. It's not going to turn into a vase of flowers in your eye. So the idea is that I can sort of fine tune that a bit more. I haven't got all of the colours for that background, but I think I'm going to put them in last. I've got these brushes which I just cleaned. I've got some greens on them. So I guess I'll do some of the darker versions of these flowers as well I can remember what they are. So I had this as the shadow colours that go in here. And I've stopped thinning it now. That's going to come all the way over. That is that. It will have a little highlight on the end eventually. There. And then maybe some shadows here. Some little bits sticking out. It's darker in there, which is interesting. Again, it doesn't look blue enough, so I'm going to make it slightly bluer. There's similar tones. Like I said, those brush mixes. are going to do an awful lot of the work. So I can get some more blues in here. There'll be a few highlights on there, so I don't want to load it up too much. Okay, so big shapes in here. What else? A few sort of sticking into here. So there's some details that I'm going to be tricky that I might be pulling out later on, but some of these petals I'll put on as positive shapes, some as negative shapes. Some of it's just going to be trying to get the language of the flowers, of how they appear. Right, I'm going to need a bit of oil here as well. Not too much, I'm going to keep it quite dry at the moment, but don't really want to use thinners up to this point. No more than I have to. Okay. That's brown colour under here, so I'm gonna pull some of that out. So there's all these interesting colours, right? There's some pinks here as well. This is getting darker slightly for where it goes into the shadow here and here, a little bit under there. Mix in on the surface, so I don't have to fuss about it too much. Anywhere else, any more of those? Yeah, a few bits here. So I'm going to end up with quite a few brushes on the go here when I really get going on it. Let's go back to that original colour and let's have a wander over here. So what did I see? Now, I've painted chrysanthemums before, but I was sort of trying to find my way a little bit as I went along. See, this is the bluishness I could see is actually starting to turn up when this colour meets the one next to it, even though actually neither of them are blue. I can check that. Slightly bluer, slightly greener. Still got that contrast with the background. a bit of that green light against it there. You can see a few of these greens in here. And they've gone again. I know, there was some. Where was I? I'm losing track of these flowers now. I'm here, I'm here, I'm here. Okay, yeah, that's making sense. Okay, we'll make this slightly darker one. That's definitely going yellower, so I'm going to use this orange again. And that's going to go a little bit in here, a little bit under there, so we'll get a bit of directionality going on. A little bit in there, is that too much? Being observed. Right. Yeah. Yeah, that's kind of working. Yeah, where was my dark pink? It wasn't one of these. I think it was this one. No. No, it couldn't have been that. That was for in here. Yeah. Well, actually, well, I've got that on the brush. Let's have a look at some of these. Yeah, I don't want to get too thick. Ooh, too thick with this because it's got to take some more paint over the top. Let's get down to there. Yeah, that's pretty good. Sideways on a few of these marks. Okay, and here, so I can actually be thinning the paint by spreading it thinner on the surface as I go along. So it would make way for what I'm going to need. Put a bit of that over here as well, I think. There we are. So there's going to be room for some extra darks to go in. This should be a nice sort of medium colour. establishing some of those shapes. Again, it's still quite a dry brush, so that whole sort of fluid thing is going to have to come later on. But that background is softening some edges for me. Talking about that negative space. Pop a bit of that in here. Change up some of those shapes in here. It's all one colour at the moment, but it will make more sense as it goes along. I was looking for that pink colour, wasn't it? But actually, it looks purple now, but that is the colour I'm looking for. And this is going under these flowers here. It's going to be greyer than that. But I tell you what, these ones here, I definitely want to get that darker colour underneath. And it's very intense. Definitely want a bit of that, bit of this, No. So those colours are very similar, those two. Yeah, so there isn't loads of oil on the surface. It's fairly understated. It's fairly limited colour range. But now that's in, I can go to this bluer one here. I can put a bit of that in. Especially where it gets a bit darker. Maybe that end one there. I can't entirely remember what this was for originally. Where else is this? this. I'm going to make a shadow colour. It's going to go... under here. Well, that's a million miles off, isn't it? It's nowhere close. Not worked at all, but hopefully it will. Okay, and down here, it's definitely a shadow. Shows through underneath here. No, not down there. Okay, my head must have moved. There you go. Yeah, it's one of the artist's biggest issues. Biggest problems is having a movable head. Really do with one of those static ones that doesn't move at all. My canvas stretcher. Don't suppose it much matters if you can tell what it is. It's not super important. There you go, there's something there. Now what's going on down here? It's about right. Okay, so while I'm still on darker colours, there's this yellowy glow coming out of some of these chrysanthemums. So I'm going to pop that in a little bit in here. That should sort of emerge slightly when the lights go on top. There's definitely quite a bit in there. What about up here? Yeah, a little bit. Probably too much. Ooh. Yeah, there's definitely some in here. Just a little pop a bit there. Right, and there's these darker pinks, but we shouldn't use that brush for it, but that's going to sit in behind here. And another one down here somewhere. Oh, maybe it'll be there. Okay. Hmm. I'm sticking with the one brush here, and it seems to be working pretty well. I'm going to go into some of these dark greens. I might even approach this black in a few places. There's these particular patterns to the leaves, which are sort of interesting. Concentrating now. So yeah, these slightly spiky leaves, which are quite fun in their way. Little spike. It's greener over here with a few little spiky bits stick out. Some little gestures. Okay, so it's over here. These sort of mini fingered leaves. Yeah, I guess that's kind of working. So I'm just going to have some of this background colour go in as well. This one, I guess. Okay. Yeah, that's doing something. Yeah, my head keeps moving around. This is very unhelpful, really. I wish I would stop it. Yeah, to keep moving my head. I think there is this sort of desire to look round the corner, as it were. Okay, I'm going to keep that brush because the background colours are quite useful. And I'm going to work up this green. So to begin with, it will darken a bit because of what's on the brush. I'm not going to chuck loads of colour on it. It's got a paler green on it. Okay, now we're getting into the language of it. Need something in between these two, so back to brush mixes again. Back to the dark one. That'll do it. I think that's probably pretty close. Okay, I was going to do this quickly, wasn't I? Let's hurry up then. I'll keep this just for general background colours. There's not much difference in between them. Oh, I can see a few. I can sort of put the mark there for that. Some of those edges. Might put a bit of that negative space back afterwards. So. If I can define that little shape of the leaf, that will explain a lot. Just make sure that crosses over into here. And lost it again. Right. I need a very dark version of this. I'm going to put a bit more red in it, even. It's changing shape a bit. So now there's a lot more mixing on the surface going on, so I can chuck this in a bit. Put out some of these shapes. And the really important thing is going to be getting the right shapes for the marks for the light on the petals. There's a few other shadows going in. And then down here I've got a similar kind of thing. we'll look for those patterns. Okay, it's pretty close. Well, I've got this green. Go for this slightly bluish version. I can put the centres of some of these flowers in. It gets a bit brighter around. Where is that? Around here. Oh, it's a little bit brighter. No, less so. This is good. Okay, so the paint's working nicely now. It's sort of it's making some interesting little shapes. It's not going as far. In terms of like pushing lights and darks and all that kind of thing. It's got a bit of that language going on. I said I'd leave the backgrounds to last, and I kind of meant it. This is putting me off. If that's way too much, that's way too much. This is pretty much pure alizarin, so I don't know. Obviously it gives me nowhere to go if it's if it needs to be dulled down, which it does. This is where I need a little bit of oil. Get it to sit up on the surface a bit more. Which means I can make lighter brush marks, but hey, again, they'll play along a little bit more. So do a few more of these little pink ones. Along here. A little extra redness to that. some of these shapes at the back. See that in a few other places, so over here I've got these few little petal shapes. I left the palette on, didn't I? This is why I need an assistant, but nobody wants to help, so sorry about that. This is actually perfect timing because it's just the bit where it's getting interesting. Got some of those lights going on here. There's a few other places in here. Especially just at the tip of the petal. Then it gets a little bit lighter, so I'll mix a slightly lighter version of that, very slightly. Where else? A few bits here. It's got these little highlights on the edge of the petals, they're quite fun as well. Okay, back into the slightly redder version. Dashes, they give us little directions of the edges of the petals. And keep loading that brush. Hopefully this will kind of explain the flower without having to do much explaining, if that makes sense. Hey. Okay, while I'm going back to this, let's go back to that pink colour, see where that needs turning up. Here we are. There's a few little brighter dashes in there. Makes this little sort of circle of petals, I guess. I suppose that's what you'd call them. Get some of those rhythms in. Oh, that's gone. I'm gonna make a really intense red. There we go. I'm putting a few little dashes just where it needs it at the edges of these. So way ahead of that in a sense. There you are. That colour needs turning. Where else? Hold Nobody did it here, I think. Clean that off and we'll go into some of the other highlights. Maybe a slightly smaller brush even, or even a round brush. Might try a round brush, see what it does. I rarely use round brushes. Scratchy at the moment. Let's create a few structures. So, the shape there. Some really clearly defined petals here. An edge of one there. Okay, let's get some of this brighter pink here. Top, even brighter lights just for the top edges of the petals. Like there. Like I said, I'm talking about trying to get the language of the flower, but there's also a certain amount of truth needing to go on. This is a long, long way off being any kind of botanical art, obviously. Very much about the feeling of it. But even so, there has to be a bit of accuracy or it's most just colourful gibberish. Where else can I use these? There we go. Let's go back to that pink. Okay. Pen's getting a bit thicker there. That's okay. I think that'll pretty much do it for the bright pink ones. Probably do with a little bit of this in the shadow again. The other interesting thing is the different flowers have different structures, so it's not just the colours that make them different, it's also how they're built. As far as I can tell, yeah, I guess they're all chrysanthemums, but they're also all different sort of designs, if that's the word. Okay, which gets me onto this small brush here. I'm going to put some of these bright shapes in first and see how they do. This is going to need a bit of water as well. That should do a good enough job of softening down. That makes it mix on the surface a bit more, which is quite a nice effect. I've still got room for some of those very bright lights afterwards. This is mixing on the surface, but it's giving me a little bit of texture as I go. Similar kind of thing from down here, so I'm going to get a bit more of that proper paint into it now and start putting in some of these bright edges. Like I said before, I've still got some very nice sort of bright highlight colours to go afterwards, so I can be a bit loose with this. So yeah, okay. Get some of these light petals going in here. It's mixing on the surface to a certain extent, which is okay. Direction with this, so it mixes into the dark. This is where it gets interesting over here. thing of reloading the brush every time, so. Get some of that background colour back in. Here. So now some of these negative spaces can really start. Whoa, what's that? There's a whole lump of skin or something. I'm going to lighten that slightly. Let's see if we can make it sort of zing out a little bit. Especially in these gaps here. Have a little play around with the tone. Make it do different things. Like in here. And there. Do with a bit more light up here as well, just to create that difference with the background of that flower. Where else can that go? Can play in here a little bit. Hey. Now I'm going to get lighter and yellow as I move across here. Accentuate some of that light, but I'll let the brush marks sort of break up a little bit. Scrub it in near the edges. Okay. It's a nice bit. I can put the really bright bits on. I'm going to go on. Oh, there's a bit of fluff. Nobody ordered that, thank you. Sets up nicely. know I'm concentrating if I go quiet. Little step back. I might spot some other things as I'm going along, but for the moment, is that 9 o'clock? I really did get absorbed in this one, didn't I? Okay. It's time for a bigger brush. Maybe a little bit of thinners. And a tiny little bit of oil. Ah, that's not a tiny little bit, but there you go. Okay, this is where that original layer is going to help. So between the two here, I think. Darker. Little point. It's kind of interesting. There. fiddle with this too much, couldn't I, if I'm not careful. What's somewhere in the middle of that? That's got to get bluer. That's going to be my shadow colour. A bit lighter at the edge. Afterwards. Even lighter than that. No, even lighter than that. Now we get lighter and yellower as it gets nearer the front like that. More oil. A bit lighter. That was another dab of yellow. Flash of light in that. I think we have some chrysanthemum. I think that's how it's pronounced. It's just about a rhythm. Any more than that? I think there is a little bit, but I think it's really subtle. And I think it comes down to some of these shapes at the back. Edges. tried it in a few places. Okay. I'm definitely over fiddling now. Where am I? Brush go. Oh, can I put it into the wash? I think I did. Okay. I think that's got it. Okay, I'm going to use this to sign it as well. Should go really horribly against that green. Is that 2 hours? It's amazing how it slots into 2 hours. Exactly. So strange. Didn't look at a clock once. So there's my... to our process. Some rather joyful chrysanthemums. Subject matter. So thank you very much for joining me again, or for the first time. I don't know if you've been here before. If it was the first time, welcome. And you can see the picture tomorrow in the Bean Shop Cafe. Oh, thank you, Anna. Oh, thank you, Virgil. Oh, thank you, Trail Boots. So I'm here every week, and on every Monday night I'll be painting a thing, whatever the hell that might be, and you can come along and watch it. So, yeah, I'll say goodnight to you all, and